No waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Pitch was in and off the plate. So hard to do anything with the pitch in that location, but somehow he got the barrel to it and hit it well. Pretty amazing.
Comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base. Trying to stay out of a double play here.
Nimmo, the base runner at first with one out. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Chased the fastball up the ladder for strike three. Here's Starling Marte. At the belt and fires. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. 2013 in the playoffs. You caught one as the Red Sox played the Rays in the division series.
I sacrificed a bracelet. It was my wrist and my hand.
He can't get there. That should be extra bases.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting him at bat. Pretty much just a textbook double into the gap. And when you can drop one in there between the outfielders, you know you're making the turn at first. Just an excellent swing.
Runner leads away at second. That one to first. And foul ball.
The strategy of winning a ball game, when you can make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So a good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four hole hitter up.
Two outs and one in scoring position.
Well, they say it's a game of inches, and that's a perfect example right there. Could have been a big swing in this game if it stayed fair.
That misses. It's a ball and two strikes. And a ball evens the count. 2-2 down. Acuna has it sized up. Puts the squeeze on that one. And that is the third out of the inning. Back here at Citi Field, here is Matt Olson. Carrasco back to work. That's a laser base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Absolutely smoked that baseball. What a swing. Sent it out way faster than it came in, of course. 113 off the bat.
And they almost caught him, but he's back in time. Righty delivers. In the dirt, and the count is 2-0.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Runner, yes, yes. Runner takes off. Swing and a miss. Throw to second, he's safe. Righty to the plate.
That's ball three. Three balls, one strike.
Fouls one away, and now 3-2. The pitch. And he walked him.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
So here's Murphy now. 1-2. In the dirt, blocked. And an excellent job keeping it right there. And the 0-1. And that skips in the dirt. Now a rip into left center. Should be extra bases. One runs in. Runner stops at third, and they're at the corners with nobody out.
His confidence level is so high. Really nice job of coming through in a big spot.
He drove that ball very well out to the deep part of the field, and you may be surprised he didn't get a double out of it, but I'll tell you, they did a great job of getting that ball back into the infield right away, and it might have been the right call to hold him at first.
Brooks Raley on to pitch here.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
Now here is Ozzie Albies. Squirts away a little bit. No advance. Good job behind the dish. Lefty out of the stretch. Runners at first and third. In the dirt, but kept close. But no advance from the runners. Riley, the runner at third. Murphy, on at first with nobody out. Next pitch misses inside. And now 3-0. So definitely a little wild right out of the gate.
Well, it could be a little tough coming from the bullpen mound to this.
Line drive. Base hit into right field. Now a long throw home. It's off the mark, and he scores. And they lead by two.
That's three singles in a row. Nice line drive to the pole side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Harris now at the plate as he swings through strike one. McNeil. Acrobatic throw for one. Over to first, safe. Now it's the DH, Marcelo Zuna. And a foul ball. Yoan. Swings through that one for strike two.
Big pitch right here. He's going to try to make a pitch that's going to produce a strikeout or a ground ball double play.
And now 2-2. Runners are at the corners, one away.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
And here it comes. Stays alive. Ripped to third. There's one. Orlando Arcia getting ready to hit.
Good swing out of him last time. Ripped a liner in the center.
Look out! And it hit him.
Now that lack of execution puts a little pressure on the defense too to try to prevent another run. It's been a rough inning, and he's not instilling a lot of confidence on the mound right now.
The Mets with a new arm on the mound, Drew Smith.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
Rosario swings through it for strike one. Bases loaded, two down. Wouldn't chase that time. And the pitch is in for a strike. Now 1-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Had him way out front of the slur. And welcome back. Here's the left fielder, Mark Canna. Here comes a pitch. That's to third. Now the throw to first on the run. Save! Daniel Vogel back at the plate.
Used the big part of the field last time. Nice liner to center.
Vogelbach, a former All-Star, 30 years old now, and he was a second-round pick back in 2011. First offering misses the mark.
Now, this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
And now 2-1.
In today's game, not that many fastball counts, but hitters still in the back of their minds, they're looking for one. 2-0 changeup call right there. Excellent pitch selection to go with.
Here's the 2-2.
Well, the hitter shows the pitcher that he's willing to go after that pitch down in the zone. So perhaps he'll come back to it. Still try to get that ground ball double play.
Arcia puts it away for the out. And there's one down.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ballgame and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit. And then from there can really settle in.
And that one wrapped foul. Canna, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Next offering is in for a strike.
Cold night tonight, Boog, and that's a pretty firm fastball right there. I tell you what, memories of getting jammed, they are creeping into my mind right now.
In plenty of time to first, two gone now. Here's the catcher for the Mets, Francisco Alvarez. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Runner at second, two down. Riley fires to first. That's out number three. We go to the top of the seventh. Now it's the right fielder, Ronald Acuna Jr.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
Chance to collect himself now as he asks for time. And now he steps off the rubber. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-1. And another ball. Next offering way upstairs.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
And out number one on the grab. Here's Matt Olson. 1-3. And that's in there for strike one. And ball one.
I got a ball, one strike.
Right-handed reliever. That one the other way. He hauls it in. Two away. Austin Riley next up for the Braves. In the air right side of the infield. And he dropped it. Sean Murphy next up for the Braves. Swings through that one, 0-1. Swing and he breaks his bat. McNeil gets it to first, and that's the third out. Back here at the ballpark, set for the last half of the seventh, and stepping in for New York, Eduardo Escobar. And a pitch. And a swing and a miss.
Well, the game plan for this offense has been pretty clear. They're being aggressive at the plate, but still finding ways to pick their spots without falling into the habit of being over-aggressive. Five hits for them on the first pitch alone, so they're swinging and connecting right out of the gates.
And that one is lifted in the air. It gets down, a base hit.
Still able to come through behind in the count right there. I really like the approach of that swing. That was a good change up on the corner, but he recognized it early, didn't get jumpy, and just smacked it to the
underhanded to second. On to Olson. That's two. Here's Francisco Lindor. And first offering is fouled off.
He's done a great job getting the first two outs. Want to get this number two hitter, get back in the dugout, and face 3-4-5 next inning.
Two down, nobody on. Got it by him for the K. All set for the start of the inning. Here's the second baseman, Ozzie Albies. And the pitch. In the air, out towards left center. Hauls it in, and there's one away. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Michael Harris. Line to left, and that gets down for a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
First pitch swing in, went up there with a plan to be aggressive. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
Swing and a miss, and he got him to chase. Falling behind 2-1. Harris stands at first with one out. That's hard hit on the line. Canna pulls it down and he makes the catch. And there's two down.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it, but sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
Slice the other way. That's a base hit. And that's going to roll to the wall. Harris coming home. He'll score, and they lead by three.
Well done. Drives in the run. Just a really nice approach to shoot that line drive to the opposite field. There's a lot of hard work and discipline that goes into getting a result like that at the plate. Doesn't come naturally for most hitters.
Well, we'll hold that thought as that's the third out, and we'll end the inning. Back here in Queens, bottom of the eighth. Starling Marte up to hit.
Got to keep things airtight defensively right here. On your toes, ready to make a play. If you can get this to the ninth with a three-run lead, it should be a W.
And a pitch. Swing and a ball popped up. That gets down for a hit. So a man on base to start the inning. And here is Jeff McNeil. That's in there. 0-1. Into center field. That'll fall for a hit. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out. Now the left fielder, Mark Canna. Line drive, base hit. Marte is waved home. He'll score easily, and it's now a two-run game. And the throw gets away. He scores all the way from first. A terrible job getting it back to the infield, and it costs them a run. Play at the plate, and he's out. He tried for the inside to Parker, and he couldn't make it. Vogelback in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Swing and a miss. And a count. Even 1-1. Left hand hitter waits. On the ground. Albies. Now two out. Brett Beatty up now for the Mets. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Just missed. Lefty continues to work, but the closer getting loose in the bullpen. The next pitch misses, and that's ball three. And the tying run is on base.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter, but he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Alvarez in the box now, takes strike one. And a ground ball to first. Diving, and he can't make the play. The throw to third. There's the tag. They get him, and that's the inning. We go to the ninth. Now the leadoff spot for the Braves, Ronald Acuna Jr. The pitch. Sneaks through, base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Everything came together for him. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Time called as the pitching coach makes a visit to the mound. One reliever still getting loose out in the pen. Adam Ottavino getting the call to the mound.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Matt Olson up to the plate. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Ottavino goes 6 feet, 5 inches, 245 pounds. He joined the team as a free agent. The 1-1. Acuna runs. Pitch is high. Throw to second. Tag. Out at second. Swing and a miss. Two balls, two strikes.
Well, on those hitters count, sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. Austin Riley now at the plate.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field. Not looking like they'll be adding any insurance runs heading to the bottom of the ninth, so it's going to be on the bullpen to hold this lead.
In the air, center field. Nimmo has it sized up. Makes the catch, inning over. Bottom of the ninth, and stepping in for New York, Eduardo Escobar. The wind of the pitch. Out towards right center field. Makes the catch, and there's one away. So up next for New York, Brandon Nimmo. Dives, can't get it, it's a base hit. Around second now as they still don't have it. And he gets there. The tying runs at third with a triple.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Left field. Fair ball. Rosario throws to second. Lindor trying to wiggle out of a rundown now. And they tag him out. Starling Marte digs in now. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Back and forth we go. A seesaw battle in the late stages of this one. Strike two.
Ahead 0-2 in the count. Sure, you've got four pitches you can work with, but throw something you can command and get this at bat over with as quickly as possible.
Albies makes his way towards it, and that will end the inning. We're in extras here. Here's the catcher, Sean Murphy.
Well, it's kind of deflating. You blow that lead in the bottom of the ninth. So here's a new opportunity. Hit the reset button, try to get some more runs, and then close it out in the bottom half of this one.
The 1-0. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Lifted in the air right center field. Nimmo ranging after it. Flashes the leather on the run and catch. One away. And next for Atlanta, Ozzie Albies. Fly ball to right. Marte moves under it. Drops into the glove. Runner tags at second. Riley caught up now trying to get to third. Safe! Here's the center fielder, Michael Harris. Swing and a miss. And it's 0-1.
Sometimes a hitter will go up there and guess, and it's not just pulling something out of the sky, but expecting, because of tendencies, a certain pitch in a certain location.
Ah, that ends the inning, so we take a break. Back here at Citi Field, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now, Jeff McNeil. Pitch. Bounce to the right. He takes it on his own. One up, one down.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there. Just rolled over it. Got the ground ball.
Here's the left fielder, Mark Canna. First offering misses the mark.
In the infield at the corners. Don't be surprised to see them come home first.
Base hit, that'll do it. Across is the winning run, and the Mets walk it off in extra innings.
Well, you come to the ballpark hoping you'll see something special that day, whether you're a player or a fan. A walk-off win, nobody forgets that. A memorable moment that'll be logged in the backs of the minds of everybody that witnessed this here today.
Close one here today, and your final 5-4. A one-run extra inning win for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.